March 1971. Muscle cars ruled the road.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Dirty Harry hits theaters, and North Kansas City Schools opens the doors to a brand new school. Winnetonka, the third high school in the district, celebrates its golden anniversary with a look back to that first day 50 years ago.
I walked in and I got emotional.
Memories come flooding back as Larry Mark, Winnetonka's first assistant principal, enters the school.
This is the most beautiful friggin' school I've ever been in, and it's kept that way all these years, 50 years. It looks brand new.
That spring, 600 students experienced a unique building.
There was an awe, you know, because there was a building like we'd never seen before.
Right there.
Dennis Nelson among the first to walk the halls.
We were in a brand new building, but it wasn't done yet.
The construction people that were building this went on strike. And so the building wasn't done, and we were supposedly to open up. We couldn't.
Classes in the school began in March, and construction continued.
Harvey was the first play we did in the Winnetonka Little Theater.
The Little Theater completed just in time.
We couldn't use the theater till just before the opening night. Had to practice in one of the big classrooms.
Winnetonka's first theater teacher set the stage for an award-winning department for years to come.
We had outstanding hair and makeup design for Hairspray.
Just the Griffin Rice from 1970 through 1990.
For 30 years, Therese collected school memorabilia, looking over hundreds of pictures, flyers, and handbooks. A rich history emerges, and a sense of pride develops when Winnetonka establishes its identity.
We get to name the mascot and the colors and everything. It was a wonderful thing.
After all the students voted.
That's what it ended up being. It was red and gold and Griffins. You know, everybody kind of had the idea that now we know who we are.
Keeping in the theme of Greek mythology.
This is the very first yearbook.
The yearbook is named.
It obviously struck a note because of our situation, starting a brand new school, that an odyssey is a journey.
Any way you want it, that's the way you need it.
The 80s meant big hair and heavy metal.
That was my lovely prom dress.
One of many success stories from Winnetonka is Kathy Nelson.
I still have my letter jacket. And as a Griffin, I couldn't be more proud.
Also in the school's Hall of Fame.
The student body at Winnetonka was overwhelmingly friendly, accepting. It was a diverse population of student body.
Walking the halls now, Kathy's school pride is still strong.
What people need to know and realize and be proud of is those first 50 years of Winnetonka have gone on to produce some amazing people in our community. I still know my high school teachers. I don't always stay in contact with most of them, but there are a few that I do. And that connection of community pride within the walls, it doesn't matter that it's brick and mortar.
The 90s brought alternative rock.
You've got mail.
AOL. And the addition of hallways A and C. Winnetonka also rings in a new ritual.
In this place, Winnetonka, for me, was like a home away from home. So for me, school was an outstanding experience.
Football player and class president Joe Blackshear and his grandfather, a Mason, saw an opportunity to build school spirit.
Hey, we can do that. You know, they wanted a victory bell put in. They needed a concrete structure. And then the idea was to put memorial bricks that are down across the path and around the structure that the bell sits on.
Built in the courtyard, the bell celebrates a football win. Knowing he's part of a Winnetonka tradition is a bit overwhelming.
That kind of hits me, you know, right here. Because, as I mentioned, the school has meant so much to me.
2-1, happy 2000!
The 2000s usher in big renovation projects at Winnetonka. The cafeteria gets a makeover. A lower gym and wrestling area are built. food rooms are updated, lights are installed on the football field, and a new modern front entrance welcomes students. Meantime, other changes are taking place inside Winnetonka.
We have people, we have students from all different cultures. We have multiple languages actually being spoken, far more so than what you had in the early 90s.
Winnetonka becomes an avid national demonstration site, the first Missouri high school to do so.
And I knew right then that Winnetonka teachers cared so much for their students.
Harper Ross credits Winnetonka for her strong work ethic and academic drive.
I would not be where I am today without Winnetonka, and I am so, so grateful for the incredible 4 years I had there.
Winnetonka's future builds on its past as construction on a new stadium is underway. Coming fall of 2021, home games finally become a reality.
Now, the community once again can feel attached to their school, and I think it's going to do great things for our schools.
Even though Larry retired many years ago, his Griffin pride is evident for each class then and now.
They were smart, they were sharp, and they were devoted to class, and as a result, they've been incredibly successful.
Thank you for 50 years of incredible service to the community and the student body, and 50 years of excellence, and I cannot wait to see what Winnetonka does in the next 50 years. All together now, all together
now. We were a family. That's the best way to put it.
Winnetonka, more than brick and mortar.
Our Winnetonka High!